At the end of April 2014, Israeli-Palestinian peace talks were suspended. And at the beginning of July, Israel launched a major military offensive on the Gaza Strip, its third in 6 years. The official aim of Operation Protective Edge was to put an end to Hamas rocket fire and destroy tunnels that supposedly gave protection to combatants. But in reality, it was civilians who, unable to escape from this 41-kilometer-long strip of land, were to pay the heaviest price. 25 medical facilities were damaged, over 10,000 people wounded, and more than 2,000 killed in less than 2 months. Medical staff at the Al-Shifa hospital were swamped, and 10 days into the offensive, an MSF team was deployed to provide them with support.
We haven't seen such levels of shelling and destruction before, and the medical teams were extremely concerned about the numbers of victims they'd find in the streets, about keeping the operating room running round the clock and so on. MSF teams were working through the night to relieve the Ministry of Health staff who were exhausted, but who had continued working, doing an amazing job.
People with multiple injuries, burns, shrapnel wounds. Trauma cases poured into Nasser Hospital in Khan Yunis in the South Gaza too. The casualties, mainly women and children, would arrive in waves, while the Palestinian surgical teams performed procedure after procedure as fast as they could. Many patients were also provided with post-operative and nursing care and physiotherapy at MSF's Gaza clinic. It was only after 50 days of conflict and shelling that an indefinite ceasefire was finally concluded.
So we're planning the next stage. We have specialized staff and are going to suggest to the Ministry of Health that we focus on reconstructive surgery, particularly for blast victims with burns, of which there are many, to continue working in the intensive care unit and to reinforce post-operative care.
Two days after the beginning of the truce, the 520,000 displaced people started to return home. Most of them found nothing but rubble.
After this war, I don't think there is a hope. What hope after all these destructions and after the old buildings that was destroyed? I think Gaza needs more, as they say, 20 years to rebuild and to re-set up all the structures in Gaza. Everything is destroyed in Gaza.
As the military offensive continued in Gaza, the West Bank was the scene of clashes of an extreme violence. Following the abduction of three young Israeli settlers in June, Israel made hundreds of military incursions and many arrests. Along the streets of the old city of Hebron, families hide behind closed shutters. Intimidated and aggressed, their homes are demolished by Israeli soldiers. Like many Palestinians, Zainab watched, powerless, as her home was destroyed.
At 3 in the afternoon, 14 military jeeps filled with soldiers arrived and two bulldozers. First, they demolished the houses up there, and then they came to us and asked us to evacuate. But we didn't evacuate as fast and easily as they wanted, so they did it by force.
Given this renewed tension, MSF has increased its mental health care programs in the West Bank, Hebron, Nablus, and East Jerusalem to provide support to hundreds of new patients, including children in a state of shock and people suffering from post-traumatic stress disorder. But they're going to need more than just emergency treatment. It will take years for them to get over the trauma of a conflict that is so far from being resolved.